What's going on, guys, and welcome back to the next episode of The Ultimate Wheel. We have way too much money for my comfort sitting in our account, like 70,000 pucks, and we've luckily been rolling lots of other things since the second or third episode where we hit that first bankrupt. So I just pray to the hut gods that nothing bad happens on this spin. Please not a bankrupt, more packs, something else, synergy booster, maybe. Open three packs, so a nice spin to get this episode going. Let's get it.
All right, so we got three packs. The team is looking all right. Remember, if you ever want to look at the stats and look at the current makeup of the Ultimate Wheel, just all you gotta do, go to the comment section, and I'll link the HutDB website, and you can see what the current situation is going for our team. Let's check it out. This is the first Gold Plus pack. Got a Milestone Andrew Ladd, and the last one is a Mitchell Marner. All right, so at least we got a special card out of the first one, which is better than we can say for most of these packs that we open up throughout these episodes. We're just skipping the animation on this one. Joel Ward, David Backes, last rare. It's, wow, Bobby Hull, legend card. Is that the third legend on our team? Oh my goodness. And that's one of the new legends that just came out, so wicked. It's too bad he doesn't have any of those synergies I want to look for, but Bobby Hull, a 92 overall legend, is definitely making our team now. All right, so one final pack, and I always say this, I'm happy with what we've got so far. So if we don't get anybody in this pack, which we probably won't, the luck is probably all run out, then I'm fine with this reward. The three packs was a success. We get Matthew Tkachuk's Ruby card, Patrick Hornqvist, and the last rare is Ryan Ellis. Not bad at all. I'm gonna have to check the lineup because 89 Ruby card Matthew Tkachuk is definitely probably one of the higher overall since we haven't been able to get as many players as we wanted to this year from PAX, at least I think, don't quote me on that. But Matthew Tkachuk following up our Bobby Hull poll is fantastic for three packs. So it might be a little unorthodox, but Evgeny Kuznetsov and Bobby Hull's face-off stats are technically the same. I just have so many people right in the right wing that can just absolutely rip bullets from the left-handed shot. I mean, Johnny Hockey, which we picked up last episode, which is pretty much the most perfect card we have right now. Voracek, Ruby Kane, and Ice Kucherov are all sitting there. I mean, let's face it, none of these guys are going to actually leave the team. And maybe McKinnon, let's check him out with his face-off, 74. So I actually think that Ruby Tkachuk that we just picked up is actually better than that. I know some of you guys saying, well, that stat actually doesn't matter. All right, so he's actually 74, so he's actually the exact same. So we're going to pick him up, throw in a card that's 4 overall. Oh, look at that Ruby line. That is looking sharp. Here we go. Panarin, Tkachuk, Patty Kane, that's a beautiful line right there. Then we got Bobby Hull, repping center. We got some different special cards. We got the Halloween, the Legend, and another Ruby card. So this team is looking pretty fierce right now. Let's get in this first game.
All right, the Chutes, let's get it. Bring on back. Come on, no, let me switch players. Oh my gosh. We left Crosby wide open in front of the net. I guess we gave him the Crosby treatment. Guys, that's not how we do this. It up, birds. Oh my god, jump deke one more time. I dare you. Tkachuk skating in. We got 2-on-1. Let's go throw it on top. Try to go wide, it didn't find the net. We're gonna go out front, and Patty Kane is there to snipe it home. A nice, slick, quick 1-tee from the hash as Patty Kane was left wide open. We tied this game up. Take it back up to the point. Subban blasts it to Niedermeyer. Gets blocked in front, but Sakic picks up the loose change. There we go. We got the advantage here right before the first period ends. I knew he was down, like his goalie kind of had that delayed response whenever he blocks a shot and goes down, and Sakic was there to pick it up. Now let's change some strategies up and do some work. There you go, Subban, let's go. Ooh, there you go. I'll show you how to jump deke and bring it in, and what a goal, Subban, dang. Didn't know you had that in you. There you go, no bucket hole. Let's win this one, get the draw back. He's leaving it open. Oh my gosh, I saw that coming from a mile away. I probably should have controlled my goalie at some point or learned how to do that. Right as I saw McDavid backing up from the hashes going far side, I knew it was in. There goes Stamkos, let's take it around. Slow and steady. Looks like his D glitched out there. Duncan Keith, take it in. Looks like you got a stick on that one. We fetch it into the corner. Stamkos back up to Bergeron. Bergeron, let's curl around, get some protection, rip it far side, there we go. Right back on top with the fourth goal of the game. We got 2-goal advantage here in the third period. Let's try and protect this lead so we can actually come out with the W. Oh man, I went for the check. Probably shouldn't have done that. Let's try and get the stick in here, and he feeds it back to Johnny Hockey, nets that one. That was kind of a little bit selfish. Whenever I have like a decent advantage going into the third period, I always do dumb stuff. I try and go for big hits and try and go for amazing plays. It never usually comes back to bite me, but I always give up a few bad goals. 5 seconds left, do nothing stupid with it. Oh my gosh, that was really close. I'm just gonna go back into the corner and we're actually gonna come away with this one. So a nice 4-3 victory on this one. The current record is 3-0-0. We only need three more wins before we can actually get to that Division 5, and we're in the top half, the upper echelon of the Hockey Ultimate Team. 23-14, Patty Kane, PK Subban, starters of the game. We did work. Let's get to the board.
Our first game is in the books, and we've already opened three packs this episode and already pulled a Legend and a Ruby card. Not a bad start for the episode. If I do say so myself, what would make everything better is if I could use that 85,000 pucks that I have sitting in my account on an actual player. Synergy boost would be absolutely perfect right now. Let's hope we can get that one. Fingers crossed for a good result, and let's see. Oh my gosh, I thought it was gonna be bankrupt. It kept going around in Tile of the Month. I don't know what's with this reward, but hey, it is a great, great, great option because we just played a guy who was 28-5 about. He probably had the same record that my team does, and I took a look at his team after all was said and done after the game was over. He had a pretty nice team. Can't wait to show you guys. Also, if you guys don't know what that means, we get to pick a player from the team that we just beat.
All right, so we have 85,000 coins ready to go right now, as you can see up there in the top right corner. And we get to pick a player from the team that we just beat. And this guy, as you can see, has a pretty stout record. The record is 28-5, five division titles, and he's in Division 5. So he's cleaning his way through the divisions just like we are. We get to challenge his team and pick one player. I really need people on defense. So I remember him having Ice Crosby, Ice Stamkos. He had Jason Spezza, flashback, Ruby Brayden Point, which is also really good. But this is a good team, so we really got to make this one worth our while. Mikhail Sergachev, flash forward card. Looks pretty tasty. Now, where I'm weak on my team, I feel right now, are people who shoot right-handed, so this Ice Stamkos should work out well. However, my right defensemen who are playing the lefty are really weak. I have Base, PK, Subban, Burns, and Doughty. So what I want to do, I feel like Doughty's been playing well. So has Brett Burns. You can't really take him off the team. So I think I'm going to replace PK Subban with this 92 Ice Erik Karlsson. So the cheapest Erik Karlsson out on the market right now is this one for 12,000 coins, which is still pretty cheap. I wonder if we're going to be able to buy Team of the Year players if we just manage to not get bankrupt from now on. But 12,000 isn't bad for an Ice Erik Karlsson. So as I said before, PK Subban has served us well. I forgot we had Justin Falk in here. First off, PK Subban is gone for Ice Erik Karlsson, and gosh, do I want to try him out? You guys might hate me for this, but I'm going to take out Brent Burns' 88 base card. 86 skating, I just need to play too much catch-up when people blast past me with fast teams now. And 89 skating from Justin Falk. It seems like he's got pretty decent stats everywhere, so we're going to give him a shot. We're going to bring him up to the big leagues and put him on the ultimate wheel. So we got two people, actually, from that one. I guess I must have pulled him from... I guess he was one of the ones I pulled when I did the team of the week trade and set. So we'll try him out. We'll see if he actually works for the team. It's time for another game. All right, we're finding ourselves against trade patches. You got to be some sort of super fan to name your entire team for the entirety of NHL 18 trade patches. That's passion, though. Sakic with the push off the draw. We got Kucherov, the fast break into the zone. Pass it back to Zibanejad, throws it on net. Oh my gosh! 28 seconds in, Mika Zibanejad has put us on the board. It's a good thing they got rid of that first minute quit cheese because, man, we're in this one. Got the lead early. Sakic passes it back to Doughty. Oh my gosh, we're getting stripped from us. Come on, we gotta be back. Bernier. Wow. Whenever I get burned on breakaways, it always seems like my goalies commit way too early to the save. This game's tied up. 2.8 seconds left. Come on. Stretch pass up to Niedermayer. Here we go. Can we get around him? We're gonna go the back forehand. Backhand. Oh, he gets stuffed there by his goalie, Carey Price. Let's go. He's throwing it to Ovechkin. He's wide open. Kachuk, Doughty, what are you guys doing? Come on, Bernier. There we go. Nice save. Gets in front of the net. Niedermayer's going to throw it up to Kachuk. He bites on us. It looks like we got a potential 2-on-1 if we stall a little bit, throw it over to Doughty. Blasts it in. Oh my gosh. Then it goes crashing into the net. Holy crap. That's a shorthanded goal right there. putting us up 2-1. I'm liking it. All right, so about a minute later, this is when he actually started to give up in the game. So we just kind of, you know, dicked around a little bit on the ice and did what we did. And it wasn't until I waited a couple minutes just to see if he really was going to come back, got that insurance goal. It's kind of a FIFA when you put the controller down against. I want to make sure if you come back, you know, I capitalized on it. Then we did important things. Like, we want to see what Erik Karlsson looked like doing drills in a Tampa Bay Lightning uniform soon. And then, of course, the last thing we did, we wanted to just see how low we could get our passing percentage. So I sat here, drew down, and started banging the passes against the boards. I just wanted to see how low I can get it. So that's what I did to entertain myself for the rest of the game. So, of course, that netted us the 3-1 victory, 2-1 legitimate, and I scored an extra goal there. So that is another win in the right direction for this Division 6 title. 4-0 on the season. Not bad. It's been a while since we lost. We only need two more victories to get there. And let's check out the final game stats. And we had 15-6. It was kind of a blowout from the start. Passing percentage 32%. Don't know if you saw that. Niedermeyer and Tkachuk. There you go. 32% is what it was. One shorthanded goal. Guys played pretty well. Let's get to our final spin. So as soon as he put the controller down, that means that we pretty much had the victory, so we could do things that we really needed to get taken care of. So we have, as it stands, 74,000 coins. Even buying an Ice Carlson off the auction house didn't really ding us that much. So let's hope we can get a synergy booster and just add some crazy good players to the team. Drop like 70, 60K on somebody, and what is it gonna be? Open three packs again. I even like reorientated the wheel around to hopefully give me something else, but it's sticking with open three packs, tile of the month. It's just our luck. It's not bad luck. I mean, we did get a Ruby, Tkachuk, and a legend, no bucket hole. Alright, so I actually got the microphone recording this time, so hopefully if we pull another legend, you guys can actually hear some clear audio. Sorry about that one. 350 points down the tube, and let's see what's in this first one. I'm not seeing any rares. A team of the week collectible, Galchenyuk and a Vladimir Tarasenko. Pretty good at the start of the year. Now he's really not going to find a place on our team. So at least our coin balance is safe for another episode, which is nice because 76,000 coins is a lot to lose in these things. Not seeing any rares off the start. That means they're good things hiding in the back. We got a games played milestone card. Then Adam Larsson is our final one. So not at all what I expected. All right, let's go. We get one final pack. We got a milestone collectible and a team of the week collectible. And last episode, we completely destroyed all of our team of the week collectibles by using them. Another milestone, just right then and there. There's another good card we're looking for, a primetime collectible as well. Marcus Johansson is the last rare. All right, so quick selling the rest. Our auction house thing is full, so that puts us back over 80,000 coins. So next episode, I'm gonna be just as nervous spinning that wheel. All right, going up against the Chicken Bears by Chicken Bear 1988. Creative name. All right, Bergeron, let's get this one. Get into his zone, score the first of the game. Carlson's gonna pick it up into the corner. We're gonna bring it out. Let's try and curl around. Oh, we curled right into his guy. McDonald picks it up, rips it top shelf right over Jonathan Bernier. And he's making us double watch these replays. Game on. Carlson's gonna walk around, stall it out. Stamkos passes it back up to Voracek. Voracek walks and blasts the top corner. Oh, thanks for laying down and getting out of the way of the shot. I appreciate that very much. And Voracek absolutely blasts the cannon shot into the top right corner of the goal. Nets this one, so tie this game up. Early in the second period, we're back in this puppy. And you better believe we're double watching these suckers. Bring it up. Bergeron, oh my gosh, these guys are fast as crap. Just put it on net. Get it into the zone. There we go. Poke check. Look, put it in the zone and good things happen. Provorov's going to feed it back down to Bergeron. He's wide open. We're going to slap it. There we go. We're clapping this one home. Oh, there we go. We got the 2-1 advantage. 9 minutes left of the game. We know we're double watching these replays, so see you guys in a sec. Huh? Hey! We got a rage. I was checking DMs on my phone and that happened. So hey, that's a nice surprise to come back to. So looks like we got three rage quit packs. Let's get it. All right, so we're here with the rage quit packs. And if you couldn't tell what happened, it was pretty funny. Since the guy originally made me watch all of his replays, I knew I was gonna do the same. I usually, if somebody scores and makes me watch the replays, I'll score three and make them watch those replays. And then on the fourth one, I'm like, I kind of show them mercy, teach them a lesson. So after I scored the second goal, I set my lines and everything, and then I knew he was, you know, was gonna be going on. Started checking my DMs and I looked up, It was rage quit. So I didn't actually get the right reaction that I wanted to, but hey, it's a rage quit. It's 3 gold plus packs because of it. That's the reward we set last season. And these gold plus packs, man, they've been hot for us this episode. We already got that legend hole, no bucket hole. And there's your 3 rares right there. Nolan Patrick, Goligoski, and Justin Schultz. Second pack of the rage quits. Let's go. Okay, Nick Schmaltz right out the bat. Right out the gate. Stars of the Month collectible as well in this pack. Why is this pack going so slow? Henrik Sedin. Last rare is Ryan Kesler. So here's something that I noticed. Nick Schmaltz's Ruby card is a center, but he does shoot right-handed, and we're pretty weak on that. He's an 89 overall, and he has 2 synergy points to Silky Smooth, which is what Wayne Simmons has. And Wayne Simmons only an 87. So I'm thinking Nick Schmaltz might be joining the team for the next episode. So that is our second Ruby card coming out of these Gold Plus packs this episode. On top of, well, as I said before, the no bucket hole card. Martin Jones is the first rare in this pack. We're looking for 2 more. Nino Niederreiter is the second one. And the last one is, oh my gosh. What is with these packs, man? Danny Heatley's card now? Are you kidding me? I don't even know where we're going to put him. Because, I mean, our left wings are absolutely stacked right across the top. And, I mean, I don't know if he can actually fit in these ones. And the synergies are all right. I mean, are we gonna sell him on the auction house? All right, so this is one we knew was going to be coming. Nick Schmaltz is wickedly better on offense than Wayne Simmons. The only thing he's not decent at is checking, but, I mean, he's an 87, so he's pretty much all right at that one. So that is a filthy line. And then it comes Danny Heatley. You know what we might have some fun with this. Let's replace Duncan Keith with Danny Heatley just to try it out. I mean, it's not uncommon to put some of these guys on defense, and Duncan Keith is pretty much like the lowest card we have overall on the team. So for the meantime, I think we're gonna try and put Danny Heatley on defense. We'll see how it works out. So that is going to conclude this episode of The Ultimate Wheel. Another fantastic, fantastic episode. We got so many good players on the team. We pulled 2 rubies, we pulled 2 legends. We got Ice Carlson on the team. We're looking really good, and we are 1 win away from going to Division 5 to the upper tier of Hockey Ultimate Team. So thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to smash that thumbs up on the video. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so yet. We're gonna have a video coming out in a couple days concerning choice packs and using the puck drop board back there. So be sure you don't miss that one. So go ahead, subscribe, turn on that notification so you can be part of the notification squad like most of you guys already are. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. This is PackDaddy. I'm out.